What about what not to do? I love asking like the lessons you've learned, the things you observed of what people did that you're like, wow,
yeah,
that's not going to be me when it's my turn.
You know, I think the work-life balance in sort of traditional fine dining restaurants is really tough. And, I mean, we go into the reasons for that, but I think that's probably irrelevant. But it's, you know, I think that that's just sort of not, you know, when you've got people working so much of their life and not able to, like, separate work from their personal life and take the time that they need to, you know, rest and reflect and recharge.
Yeah.
It's just not setting up, you know, a sort of sustainable, scalable.
Yeah.
You know.
Did I cut you short?
No.
So I agree 100%. And, you know, it's weird because I sit in this position where I get to make an example of successful people. Mm-hmm. And to make it in this industry, or to at least to have the perception of making it in this industry, I've noticed to what you're saying that, like, should I really be making an example of these people? Have these people really figured it out?
Right.
Or are they just projecting this image of, you know, we're the best and, like, all's good. But internally, like, at home and, like, emotionally and,
right,
you know, physical health and all that, like, emotional health, like, are these people we want to aspire to be like?
Sure.
It's a real question, an inner dialogue that I have to be like, should I be promoting these people and what they, sure, do? Like,
fascinating.
So what are your thoughts when I say that?
Well, I agree. I mean, I think it's, I mean, to me, in my mind, it's, you know, I think that is doable over a, you know, in a short term. I mean, I think you see a lot of these restaurateurs and teams sort of, you know, racing and just grinding it out, and it's just going to lead to burnout.
Yeah.
I don't know if, you know, if that's just a sustainable, long-term viable approach.
Well, I think this is why it's so important for us to have conversations, because, mm-hmm, like, I talked to, like, literally, like, the best restaurants in the most successful, you know, biggest cities out there, and from the outside looking in, they're having, like, G Crew, like, Food and Wine, like, all these, like, publications, these, yeah, awards, James Beard, Michelin, sure, stars, but they're barely making payroll,
right?
You know, and it's like, what are we doing? Why are we celebrating this?
100%.
You know, like, we need to take a few steps back and really start to, like, you know, set new standards.
Agreed.
I mean, maybe we're getting ahead of ourselves. Maybe we can reflect on what those, yeah, standards look like in the future.